Hello, so here is my latest creation. It's basically pressure sensor that you can connect to any valve, either on a tire or for me it will be on a bottle of beer because I would like to monitor the pressure of my home brewing system. So I have added to this cap a valve which is glued with epoxy into the cap, and I've put some pressure into the bottle. The system is working with a sensor, a pressure sensor, which is connected to 5 volt and outputting voltage which is directly proportional to the pressure. This voltage is fed into an analog to digital converter, and this ADC runs on this ESP32 MCU and is sent directly to the cloud of the Firebase messaging solution, which is a Google Cloud messaging solution. This Firebase cloud messaging can notify any phone which is registered to the system. So you have written an application which is connected automatically to the cloud, and I receive right now when I will have powered the system with a very classical USB power bank. Here it is. As soon as the system is powered, you can see the blue flash. So the blue flash is indicating a connection to the cloud, so at quite high frequency. And you can see new points arriving in real time on the application. What I will do now, I will connect the system to the bottle. For sure, it will leak because it's not an easy to do. I will lose some air. So here it is. Hop. So you can see immediately the system, which is stabilizing at 0.8 bar, roughly. So it was at 1.6 bar at the very beginning, and I lost quite a lot of pressure. So the system is running in real time. You can monitor the value more precisely. So here we are at 0.84 bar, and it will run forever. Look at the curve. I will shut down the application. I will even close it from the application drawer, and I will close lock my phone, so it's locked. The system is still running, so you can see here the blue flash indicating that the values are sent to the cloud. I will now reopen the system and relaunch the application. And you can see that more points have been added during the time when the phone was locked. What you can do also is, of course, communicate with the Bluetooth in order to fetch the values and to set up the parameters. So here is a touchpad. So, what you have seen here is that when I touch the touchpad, the system is booting with the Bluetooth low energy on. As soon as the application is connected to the Bluetooth, you can change any parameter you want. And for example, you can change the sampling period and put it to let's say 15 seconds. Oops, sorry. Okay. You can also calibrate the system. For this, you need to put the zero value, that is the value which is output when the sensor is without any pressure. Then you can put the pressure to a certain amount of pressure, which is for example 3 bars. and monitor the raw value, which is output by the sensor. And then the conversion is done to display the right value. So as soon as I close the application, after 10 seconds, the device will shut down and enter into the new loop of application. Once again, Bluetooth parameters have been sent to the device and it's finished. I close the app, the device will shut down, and the new parameters will be applied. So here it has shut down. It will now boot every 15 seconds. So it's longer. I would say that for regular use, 1 point every 15 minutes is really enough. Okay. So here is my solution. As you can see, it's very simple. The pairing is automatic. You just have to send the Wi-Fi parameters to the with the set Wi-Fi. So you just have to send the SSID and your password for the device to boot. The connection to Firebase is automatic. The pairing between the phone and the device is also automatic. And furthermore, if you have many phones, you can register as many phones you want to the device. And Firebase will then send the values to any of the phones which are registered. So it's very handy if you want to share your brewing with some friends. Goodbye. Hello, so here is my latest creation. It's basically a pressure sensor that you can connect to any valve, either on a tire, or for me it will be on a bottle of beer, because I would like to monitor the pressure of my home brewing system. So I have added to this cap a valve which is glued with epoxy into the cap, and I've put some pressure into the bottle. The system is working with a pressure sensor which is connected to 5 volt and outputting voltage which is directly proportional to the pressure. This voltage is fed into an analog to digital converter, and this ADC runs on this ESP32 MCU and is sent directly to the cloud of the Firebase messaging solution, which is a Google Cloud messaging solution. Firebase cloud messaging can notify any phone which is registered to the system. So you have written an application which is connected automatically to the cloud, and I receive right now, when I will have powered the system with a very classical USB power bank. Here it is. As soon as the system is powered, you can see the blue flash. So the blue flash is indicating a connection to the cloud, so at quite high frequency. And you can see new points arriving in real time on the application. What I will do now, I will connect the system to the bottle. For sure it will leak because it's not an easy to do. I will lose some air. So here it is. Up. So you can see immediately the system, which is stabilizing at 0.8 bar, roughly. So it was at 1.6 bar at the very beginning, and I lost quite a lot of pressure. So the system is running in real time. You can monitor the value more precisely. So here we are at 0.84 bar, and it will run forever. Look at the curve. I will shut down the application. I will even close it from the application drawer, and I will close lock my phone, so it's locked. The system is still running, so you can see the here the blue flash indicating that the values are sent to the cloud. I will now reopen the system and relaunch the application, and you can see that more points have been added during the time when the phone was locked. What you can do also is, of course, communicate with the Bluetooth in order to fetch the values and to set up the parameters. So here is a touchpad. I retry. Okay. Oh, shit. So what you have seen here is that when I touch the touchpad, the system is booting with the Bluetooth low energy on. As soon as the application is connected to the Bluetooth, you can change any parameter you want. And for example, you can change the sampling period and put it to let's say 15 seconds. Oops, sorry. Okay. You can also calibrate the system. For this, you need to put the zero value, that is the value which is output when the sensor is without any pressure. Then you can put the pressure to a certain amount of pressure, which is, for example, 3 bars. And monitor the raw value, which is output by the sensor. And then the conversion is done to display the right value. So as soon as I close the application, after 10 seconds, the device will shut down and enter into the new loop of application. Once again, Bluetooth parameters have been sent to the device and it's finished. I close the app, the device will shut down, and the new parameters will be applied. So here it has shut down. It will now boot every 15 seconds. So it's longer. I would say that for regular use, 1 point every 15 minutes is really enough. Okay. So here is my solution. As you can see, it's very simple. The pairing is automatic. You just have to send the Wi-Fi parameters with the set Wi-Fi. So you just have to send the SSID and your password for the device to boot. The connection to Firebase is automatic. The pairing between the phone and the device is also automatic. And furthermore, if you have many phones, you can register as many phones you want to the device. And Firebase will then send the values to any of the phones which are registered. So it's very handy if you want to share your brewing with some friends. Goodbye.